Hello, this is Spartan Commander, and this is the 247th Rome Total War Brotherhood game that I've put onto YouTube. The team I'm in today consists of Brotherhood member Cal, who has bought the Rome Brucio faction. And then we have Brotherhood member Lion Dwarf. He's called himself a tribe called Quest, but it is Brotherhood member Lion Dwarf, and this is his first game in I think about 6 months. He's had a bit of a break from RTW, and he's just come back tonight, Friday, and I believe this is the first game he's played in approximately 6 months, so it'll be interesting to see how well he does. And then our third teammate is Brotherhood member Uther, who has bought the Rome Julio faction. Now if you look at his infantry, I think he's only got about 11 infantry and 2 archers, so that's a very low amount of infantry to bring to the modern day battlefield. As I say, he's got 2 archers as well, and if you notice he's got 5 heavy cavalry and 1 fast moving light cavalry unit there. Now one of the factions we're facing in this battle is Germania, and I'm just wondering whether Uther's bought this fast moving unit here to maybe try and pre-activate the berserkers, if you know what I mean, activate them before the Germania general's ready to do it himself. And if you notice here, if you look at the good upgrades on Uther's cavalry, you can see he's got 7 upgrades on that one, but I think the rest of his cavalry have got 8 upgrades on, so that's 2 experience stripes, gold shield, gold attack. So these cavalry are really tough. As you know, Praetorian cavalry are really good anyway, but you shove that many upgrades on them and that really makes them elite. So looking at that army, it should be interesting to see how well he does. Say he's only got 11 infantry there, but used wisely, I think that army could do quite well. And if we look at his general unit there, can you see that he's got an urban cohort general unit for this battle, and it's got 9 upgrades, so it's fully upgraded. That's 3 experience stripes, gold shield, gold attack, so that really is an elite unit. And our fourth team member is myself, Spartan Commander, who has unusually bought the Greek Cities faction. Sometimes I get asked why I'm called Spartan Commander, and I very rarely use the Greek Cities faction, and that is because when Rome Total War first came out, for the first 3 months of the game I only played with the Greek Cities faction, hence my name Spartan Commander. So that's where I got my name from. So there's our team there. Looks quite experienced, but you wait till you see the other team. This battle's got the ingredients to be a classic, and I hope you enjoy it. At this stage of the battle, I thought we'd have a look at my my Greek Cities army and talk about why I bought it. As you can see here, I've got 4 long-range Cretan archers there, and and then the rest of the army are Spartans and armoured hoplites there. Now if you notice, I've split my army into 2 distinct armies, the A and B army here. The reason for that is because we're facing Germania, and that's the main reason I've bought this faction today. And the reason I've split my infantry into 2 armies is because a canny Germania general, or some of them, will attack in 2 places at once. They'll throw in like a weaker attack, maybe with a berserker unit in one part of our battle line, but then they'll put their main attack in another part. So what I find is by splitting my army into 2, that gives me a lot of flexibility where I can move my either of my armies to help my teammates there. So this is my kind of anti-Germania army there, but some members, if you remember a RTW player called Tigranus, he used to bring 4 or even 5 eagle units in his Roman army, because the reason that Germania make Roman armies a rout is because of the fear factor they bring with their night raiders and berserkers. And of course the fear factor lowers the morale of enemy troops. So when their morale is really lowered and they get hit by a big enemy hit, then that's what makes them rout. So by bringing all those eagle units, 4 or 5 eagle units, that gives morale, he said that that kind of neutralized the fear factor that Germania had and kept his troops fighting. So there you go, there's a possibility there. If you're facing Germania and you want to bring Rome, maybe try 4 or 5 eagle units within your Roman army and see, you know, for yourself, try a bit of an experiment to see if that actually works. As I say, for this particular battle I decided to bring the Greek cities because they got excellent morale, and as I say, if you split the armies into 2, they should be able to help my allies out against the Germania attack. So it'll be interesting to see how well this army does. And as I say, it is an old army. And here is the other team. We have Brotherhood member Steve Longshanks, who's bought the Rome SBQR faction. Looks a pretty tough army to me. And then our next teammate is Titans Hades. A lot of you will know the Titans clan, a very good clan. As I say, you don't see them fighting that much these days. And I see that Hades has bought the Seleucid faction. Just have a quick look at his army there. You can see he's got the Silver Shield Legionnaires at the front of his pikemen there. Probably good pilot shield units there, just to soak up some of the enemy pilots. And I see he's got four of the heavy cataphract tank cavalry and two of their chariots there. So that's a pretty good, well-balanced Seleucid army there. And with Hades in charge of it, my guess is it's going to do very well. And then their third teammate is Brotherhood member JGP, who has bought the Rome SBQR faction. And then we have a look and have a talk about the Germania faction here. As you can see, he's bought Archer Long Range Arch unit, the Chosen Archer Warband units there. These guys have got long range and pretty good tough archers as well. They've got pretty good specifications, difficult to kill, as they got long range. And then we've got the infamous Chosen Axemen there. These guys are effective against armor and used correctly can cut swathes through heavily armored Roman troops. I see he's got a lot of those Chosen Axemen there. And then we move on to the Berserkers. Remember, these Berserkers are based on real historical characters that used to literally go berserk in battle. Usually they were drunk, or they'd had a cocktail of drugs, or they genuinely had mental health issues. And even out of battle, these men had an aura about them of, don't come near me, keep away from me. And in battle, both friend and foe alike tried to avoid them. They were seen after battles often running around battlefields naked, covered in blood and gore, and screaming like banshees. And this game reflects the toughness of those berserkers. I'd just like to show you the difference in size between the berserkers and the ordinary infantry in this game. And as I say, the specifications of the berserkers are very, very good, and they've got a big fear factor as well. Now we move on to the Gothic cavalry. Now these cavalry are extremely good cavalry. If you check their specifications, they're one of the best cavalry in the game. So I think that's a pretty tough Germania army there. And I think used correctly, this army could prove incredibly effective in this battle. And as I say, that's why I've bought my Greek cities to match it. But Germania is a very unusual faction, because used incorrectly, it can be incredibly fragile. And if you get the charge wrong and they start to suffer casualties, they will rout en masse. But they also can be battle-winning troops as well if used correctly. A real enigma. Here at the very early stage of the battle, I just wanted to show that how my three Roman allies are close together there. Can you see they formed up close together? And this really helps me with my two pike armors here. If any of my allies are attacked by that Germania, in a combination of, say, Germania and the enemy Rome there, if they attack any of them, I can move my two armies out very quickly, and they will be very effective at holding back the Germania attack. So if ever you bring pike faction as an anti-Germania army, see if you can get your teammates to keep close together, as it makes it more easier for you to be able to support them when they're attacked. As you can see, the enemy is quite spread out here, and as I say, this should be an interesting battle to watch, and I hope you enjoy it. Okay, at this stage of the battle, can you see that Brotherhood member Lion Dwarf with his Julier army is moving out to our left flank to face Brotherhood member Steve Longshanks with his SBQR army there. Now, Lion Dwarf is quite an attacking player. As I say, he hasn't played for approximately 6 months. So it'll be interesting to see if he's still as attacking as ever. And by the looks of the way he's moved his army out to that left flank to face Steve, my guess is he may well even try a flanking action on Steve there. We'll just have to wait and see there. As you can see, the SBQR general's moving his cavalry a little bit further out to our left there. And as I say, Lion Dwarf has brought his cavalry back over to this left flank there. both Steve and Lion Dwarf can both be attacking players, so it wouldn't surprise me if things start to kick off on our left flank here. With such attacking players there, as I say, wouldn't surprise me there. As you can see, the main Germania army is over on our right flank, although the Germania army is moving over towards our left flank there. So they may well be looking to do an attack over on that left flank. If you notice, I keep my two Greek cities armies at the back of my allies there, just to be able to move forward and support when I can. Right, if you notice, as I say, Lion Dwarf is moving his entire army further and further over to our left there, and he's drawing Steve Longshanks' SBQR army over to that left flank there. Now, whether Lion Dwarf's tactic here is to try and isolate Steve, maybe that might be what he's trying there. Let's just pause the game for a second to take stock of exactly what's happening. As you can see here, this is how we've all formed up, and over we're all moving left here. As you can see, I've got my Greek Caesar armies at the back, ready to move in and support when necessary. But as I say, it seems like we're all shifting over to the left at the moment, even the enemy troops, the Germania army, and we are as well. So it'll be interesting to see if, as I say, if Lion is trying to isolate Steve over on our left flank there. You see those two cavalry, Germania cavalry units charged into Uther's, one of Uther's pilot shield units there as they were moving. That would have caused a lot of casualties to AORD's end of 53 men, nearly lost 20 men in that one surgical hit by that Germania cavalry. That was a nice move there by Bob. As you can see, we all seem to be slightly moving over to our left flank, towards our left flank at the moment, both the enemy and our team. We're kind of drifting in that direction there. Right, as I said, Steve is moving over here, and I just wonder whether Lion Dwarf is trying to draw Steve over to our left to try and maybe try and isolate him if he can. But as I say, Steve's been playing the game for years, very experienced, and can be a very aggressive player there. So it'll be interesting to see what actually transpires on this left flank of ours. But by spreading the my Roman armies out a bit, my allies' Roman armies out a bit, it makes it more difficult for me to cover with my two pike armies. Can you see? If I can see some berserker units moving over to our left flank here, so I need to watch that with one of my Greek cities armies. But if you notice, the bulk of the Germania army is staying over towards our right flank. Like I said to you earlier, some canny Germania generals do try and attack in two places at once, especially when they're facing counter pike factions, if you see what I mean. You see Lion is still moving over further and further to our left. Still, I think, trying to draw Steve over there. As I said earlier, I think Lion is just trying to maybe try and isolate Steve here. And if you notice, there's a gap starting to form between Steve and his allies, and also a gap between Lion's parts of his army that he's moved over here and his own army. If you notice, I'm moving one of my Greek cities army over in support. Right, just pause the game for a second to show you, I think, what a tactical thing's happening here. Let's say Steve's moved over a long way to our left here and has become a little bit isolated in his quest to counter Lion's flanking action. But can you see Uther bringing his Julia army over there, looking to be a blocking force, looking to cut Steve off from his allies? And then Steve would be really isolated if Uther can cut him off from his allies. And then he'd be very susceptible to infantry and cavalry attack from our side if we can isolate him. There's a general overview of the battle as it stands at the moment. You see I've got one of my armies still over there on the right because there's a lot of Germania troops still there, and Cal's got his Julio force facing the enemy SBQR infantry there. But as I said earlier, I got a feeling that the main battle could kick off on our left flank here. Let's say there's a general overview of the battle as it stands at the moment. Watch Uther's army. As I say, I think he's going to try and cut off Steve and get in between Steve and his allies there. Nice tactical move there by Uther. And if you notice that Steve's moving further and further away from his allies here, and he is really isolated now. Can you see he's so isolated from his allies now? He's got some Germania cavalry there, and I've noticed those three berserker units have moved over to this flank as well. Can you see the three berserker units there? Let's just pause the game for a second. Close in there. Let's see, there's one berserker unit there charging him. There's two, and there's a third one there at the back as well. So there's three berserker units coming over here to help Steve. But both Uther and Lion Dwarf there are trying to take out Steve there. But I think Steve's allies have seen what's happening. They're trying to move over as fast as they can to help him. So there's a general overview picture of what's happening on our left flank there. Let's say Steve's pretty isolated, so all our Lion Dwarf's infantry and cavalry and Uther's infantry and cavalry are charging in there trying to take out Steve. If you notice there, can you see the berserkers have been activated there? Germania berserkers have been activated. Or two of them. I can see the two banners flashing above the berserker units to show they've been activated. Do you notice Cal's Brutii cavalry charging into Steve's infantry as well? There's a heck of a lot of pressure on Steve's infantry here. He's holding extremely well there. If you notice, I'm taking my one of my Greek cities armies over there as well to try and support against the berserkers. But we have become extremely spread out here over on our left flank. And as I say, I think the tactic there was actually to try and draw Steve over there and try and isolate him. But he's getting a lot of support now from the Germania cavalry. Berserker, Germania berserkers, and I see the Seleucid pike general now is moving his men over as well. Let's just pause the game for a sec. So as you can see there, berserkers have been activated and are charged into my allies' Julia army. I've moved one of my Greek cities armies over to try and counter the berserkers there, but Steve's it's been taking a heck of a lot of hits here by cavalry and infantry, and he's still holding really well. I think probably we've been hoping that we might be able to take him out a bit easier than this, but he's holding extremely well there, and we've expended a lot of troops on that left flank to try and take him out. Let's say I've got my Greek cities army there trying to fill in that gap. As I say, the Seleucid general and berserkers are there. As you can see, a lot of the Germania effective against armor axemen are still waiting to be charged in there. And over on our right, you can see that JGP's cavalry now are chasing down some of my archers. There you go. I was concentrating so much on my infantry movement there, I forgot about my archers. And then they're probably going to be taken out by those SBQR cavalry. So that was a mistake that I made there. And well seen by JGP there with those SBQR cavalry. The same, moving back to our left flank here. As we said earlier in the game, we thought the battle may well kick off here, and that's where it seems to have kicked off. Right, can you see we've got a lot of Julii, red Julii cavalry and green Brutii cavalry there that were charging into Steve's infantry, trying to get him to rout. As I say, I think Lion Dwarf's plan there was, as I said, to isolate Steve and then take his army out as quickly as we could. But Steve's army's proven a lot more stubborn than what we were hoping for, and he's managing to hold very well there. Here you can see Uther's really well upgraded cavalry charging into Steve's infantry as well, and bang as that cavalry hits. But still, Steve's infantry are holding there. I can't see any mass rout of his units. He's doing extremely well in holding there. You see, my allies are charging their cavalry in, they're doing the right thing, they're pulling back, rallying, getting ready again, and then charging back in, always trying to get the full cavalry charge bonus that we talked about so many times in different battle videos. Right, can you see, I think as Uther pulls his cavalry back, or even Lion Dwarf there, rallied and then charging back in. Right, let's just pause the game for a second here. As you can see, Steve's army is still holding really well against those big attacks we're putting in. Can you see the Seleucid generals bringing pikes round the flank here? Nice little move there. We're still trying to charge our cavalry in. They're still trying to take out Steve's army. Meanwhile, over on our right flank here, you can see that Cal's pulling back. Yeah, I think he can see there's a problem over there on our left flank, and he's trying to take some reinforcements over there. But he's left one of my armies there facing the enemy SBQR Rome army there. You see, I got my other army there trying to face a Seleucid army there. So it kind of, my two armies are side by side fighting, trying to hold back the enemy there, where my allies are trying to take out Steve if they can. As I say, there's a general overview of the battle as it stands at the moment. You see Uther charging his cavalry in, he took them back, rallied them, and then charged them back in again, getting that full cavalry charge bonus. If you notice, the Seleucid general did a nice tactical move there, took a pike unit around the side of our around the flank there. He's got the pikes now into the back of our allies' cavalry. As I say, Steve's still got units holding there, so he's done extremely well against a really vicious attack that my allies were putting in there. Right, can you see that Germania cavalry has just charged into tired Julii troops? Right, let's pause the game for a second. Right, remember that my allies are the red Julii and the green Brutii. Can you see a lot of my allies' red Julii units are starting to rout there? That was a nice little cavalry, Germania cavalry hit went in there into tired battle damaged troops and have routed a lot of our Julii allies there. As you can see, Cal spotted the danger and sent some units over there. Cal's always a great team player there. Whenever he plays, and it's really good him sending units over there to support. You can see, say this is a general look at the battlefield here. You can see that the SBQR general didn't want to take my pikes on head on, so he's moving them around the flank there against Cal's Brutii units. He's got cavalry over there as well, ready to charge in. As unfortunately, whenever you bring Greek cities, you do put your allies at a cavalry disadvantage. So I'm just hoping that these Spartans will make up for not having cavalry with their great specifications, and maybe the way that I'm trying to use them. I think to be a good pike general, you need fast reactions and good micromanagement skills. Unfortunately, my reactions have slowed a bit over the years, so that's why you don't see me bringing pike factions very often. But let's say it would be interesting to see how this old Greek city's army does. Right, can you see the enemy SBQR cavalry have got kind of in behind us here and looking to charge into the back of our engaged Julii infantry there. And bang, as that cavalry charges in. You notice I'm bringing one of my Greek city's armies over there to try and cover the rear as much as I can of my engaged fighting allies' troops there. Remember, just at a glance, my team is green Brutii and red Julii, and the enemy are SBQR, Germania, Seleucid, and Seleucid there. Just pause the game for a second here. Right, as you can see, we've got Uther's Julii units and Brutii units there. If you notice, my Greek city's armies are both combined here in the center. One of the armies is facing Seleucid pikes. I'm bringing my other main army, the A army, over to help my Julii teammates against the enemy attack that's going on here. But if you notice, can you see our green Brutii ally is a bit exposed? Can you see Cal's infantry is a bit out away from his allies there? And I'm a bit worried if he gets isolated over there, there's a lot of enemy troops that could cut him off. So I hope he tends to come back, because you see he's moving units still out at the moment. Nice aggressive attacking moves there by Cal, but I don't really want to see him isolated. Can you see the enemy moving in, trying to cut him off from the rest of us? Another nice SBQR cavalry charge going in there. As you can see, there's a lot of Germania effective against armor axemen charging in as well. There's Seleucid legionaries charging in as well. There's a lot of enemy troops. There's lots of things going on all over the battlefield at the moment. I'm just trying to to concentrate on what I can here. Right, can you see Cal's army is surrounded basically on three sides now. One big cavalry hit maybe into the back of those of his Brutii troops with all that pressure they've got on them, and I see he's got Brutii units starting to rout. One big cavalry hit would probably rout most, and there, can you see the enemy SBQR cavalry have spotted that? And bang! Cal's general's been taken out now. Just to pause the game for a second, remember that the green Brutii army was on our team there, and most of its units have just been taken out. You remember we were seeing Cal getting a little bit isolated there, and the enemy took full advantage of that and cut him off, and now have routed all his units. Meanwhile, back here, over on our kind of right flank, if you like, Spartans are still fighting against Silver Shield Legionnaires there. And we've got some SBQR infantry charging in as well. There's not a lot of our Julii allies left at this time in the battle. And I would say at this stage, looking at what troops are left on the enemy team, and bearing in mind they've just wiped out Cal's army, things are not looking very good for our team. So I would say that, as I say, looking at the battle at the moment, it looks very much like our team is beginning to lose this battle here. If you look at the sheer number of enemy troops that are left there now, and just look at what units we have got left there, you can see that, as I say, things are not looking that good. At least Uther and Lion Dwarf have still got their generals there, so they're still giving morale to our troops. But if you notice there, I think the enemy can sense victory after taking Cal's army out. Can you see them charging in now? They may well start kind of rolling us up from left to right now. As I say, being a good pike general, you need good micromanagement skills and fast reactions. So, as I say, I feel my reactions have slowed a bit, but I'm still going to try and do the best I can with this old Spartan army. But as I say, looking at the overall battle picture at the moment, I'm sure most of you would agree things are not looking very good for our team there. I see Lion's general's just been routed there, so that's some more morale that our team will be losing. Nice tactical move there by the enemy. Can you see them flanking? They don't want to take my pikes on head on. I spotted that now, and I've moved a pike unit out to try and counter that flanking movement. Notice I was a bit slow getting that unit out, unfortunately, but it's managed to hold them up a little bit. I'm getting another unit out behind that unit there, trying to stop them getting in behind my Spartan unit. Let's just pause the game for a second. Just give you an overall picture. So remember that the team that I'm in have got red Julii, green Brutii, and the Greek cities, and the enemy are purple SBQR, Germania, and Seleucid. So just at a glance there, you can see who the enemy is and who our allies are there. But you can see the enemy closing in behind us and flanking us there. And as I say, there's not a lot of our team left, and just purely looking at the units left on the battlefield there, I would think it'd only be a matter of time until we might have lost this battle. As you can see, the enemy are closing in on all sides here, trying to get in behind my engaged Spartans there. Looks like they're trying to force their way in, as I said, trying to get behind. They know that the weakest point of any pike unit is its flank, and especially its rear, so they're trying to close in. I'm trying to react to their attacking strategy here. See that Germania cavalry got in behind, straight into one of my Julii allies there, who's now routed. I think we just got the SBQR general there, which is always good news. Right, just pause the game for a second once again. Can you see all the enemy units here? All that infantry waiting to charge in. They've got cavalry advantage. As you can see, infantry advantage here. Most of our Julii allies have routed. I think there's two or three units of Julii left, and just my tired Spartans left as well now. So I would think, looking at the general overview of this battle, it say it's not going so well for our team at this time.
The gods be praised! The enemy general is dead.
See a lot of good tactical movement by the enemy team there, getting cavalry and infantry in behind my Spartan units, hitting the flank of my Spartan units there. I'm trying to keep my units tight if I can, and trying to face any oncoming danger that's coming at me there. I've noticed a lot of the enemy SBQR units are starting to rout, so that's a good sign. Good sign for us there. I think Uther's general unit's just been taken out there.
Unworthy as friends and no more use today. They are running.
As you see, I'm just trying to face my Spartans towards the incoming enemy troops there. I noticed that Germania general just going to send his axemen in until I faced it with some pikes head on. Then he wisely backed them off there then. Right, can you see this couple of Spartan units? You see that the one, I think, just got an upgrade on when it shined there. I think they get an upgrade then. But if you notice, those two units are fighting back to back, facing the enemy coming in from both sides. If you notice, I'm sending reinforcements over now to try and start taking out that attacking force that are attacking those two units.
The enemy show their true virtue.
See that Germania axe unit coming in behind to go into the back of my pike units. But the Germania morale, as we said before, is not that brilliant. And you notice that unit routed just as it touched the Greek cities unit there. Right, you can see the enemy charging in there. They've still got big cavalry advantage. I know those enemy cavalry are battle damage, but there's still power in that cavalry.
The gods be praised! The enemy's hearts are full of fear, and now they flee.
Still, see, do you notice that cavalry charged in to try and take out my Julii allies there? Didn't really want to go for the Spartan pike units there with the cavalry. So, as I say, this is extremely close, a really, really close battle at the moment. But it looks like our team may well have turned this battle around. I think we'd all agree earlier that it looked pretty bad that, you know, especially when Cal lost his army there, that we were going to, we're probably going to lose. But if you look at the dead on the battlefield here, you can see how intense the fighting has been during the course of this battle. Thick piles of dead all over the battlefield here. So it just goes to show how intense the fighting was all the way through this. But it does look like our team has managed to go on and turn this battle around here, and it looks like we've actually gone on to win this battle. I see there's a couple of enemy SBQR units left, cavalry unit, and I think there's an infantry unit left. But they're so battle damaged, they're so battle damaged, they're probably going to rout on contact with any of our troops there.
Victory!
And there you go. I think the general just admitted defeat. So unbelievably, we managed to turn that battle around there, which is surprising. First thing I'd like to say is really well played to everybody in the game there. As you see, it was a very close victory. I think if this game actually gave a very close victory, then that's what I think this battle would have been. Very close. Really well done to Chimera Bob, JGP, Titans Hades, and Steve Longshanks. Nice attacking moves by you guys, great supporting moves, and I think for a lot of the battle I really did think, you know, you guys were going to win there. I noticed Steve's got 935 kills, but remember, he was defending a lot of the time. This battle gives good kills for attacking. Can you see Cal He's only got 762. He did a lot of good tactical moves, but unfortunately got cut off, as you saw, and taken out. So that's why his kills were not that good there, because as I say, this game does reward attacking play there to give you good kills. Just have a look at, as a matter of interest, just look at the Spartan kills there. The armored hoplites didn't do so good, but if you look at the Spartan hoplites kills, as you can see, they did quite well there. Spartan hoplites. Cretan archers, well, of course, you remember what I said? I forgot about them, and they were taken out by cavalry, so they didn't do so good there. But anyway, just to say, really well done to everybody in the game. As I say, I hope that was a good display of an anti-Germania pike army. As I say, pikes usually are a good counter against Germania, as long as you kind of maybe split them up so you can use them flexibly on the battlefield, because you can almost guarantee that a Germania general will be looking, he'll move fast and he'll be looking to strike where he can. So you need to be fast and flexible with any anti-Germania pike army you bring. Anyway, so this is Spartan Commander saying, hope you enjoyed this close victory battle. Look forward to seeing you soon, and bye for now.